This video explains how to configure the FlexZone Wireless Gate Sensor. In this video, we will use the Senstar's UCM software to configure the wireless connection between the sensor module and the FlexZone processor, configure the intrusion detection parameters, configure the supervision settings, configure equipment failure settings, configure the sensor module's auxiliary input, which monitors the status of a gate contact. To perform these procedures, you will require a Windows laptop running the UCM software and a USB cable. You will also need the serial number of your sensor module. The serial number is printed on a label on the bottom of the unit, as well as inside on the circuit board itself. Before you start, make sure your sensor module and FlexZone processor are installed and powered on. Connect your laptop to the FlexZone processor using the USB cable. Start the UCM software. The UCM software will automatically detect the FlexZone processor. Click Connect. Once the connection is established, select the GSM Config tab. The GSM Config tab shows all the parameters required to configure the wireless gate sensor. Step 1. Configure wireless connection. The first step is to configure the wireless connection between the sensor module and the FlexZone processor. Select the Enable box. This enables the receiver card installed in the processor. Select the locale. In North America, use FCC. In Europe, use ETSI-CE. Select the RF channel. If you have only one processor with a receiver card at your site, you can use any channel. If you have multiple processors with receiver cards, each processor must use a unique channel. Next, click on one of the numbered subtabs. They contain the settings for individual sensor modules. Enter the module serial number. Click the Download button to save the changes and make them active. After the processor restarts, it will automatically connect to the sensor module. Click the GSM status tab and observe the COM status light for the configured sensor module. It will turn green when a connection is established. This process may take several minutes. Note, if you are using the solar-powered sensor module, leave it in a sunny location for several hours prior to configuration to ensure an adequate charge. Examine the link budget status light. If the link is red or low, click the Align button to display the alignment plot. Click Record and observe the signal strength between the FlexZone processor and the sensor module. The graph is updated in real time, and you can use it to find the optimal placement and orientation of the processor and its antenna. Click Stop and close the window. You can save the graph for future reference if required. Step 2. Configure the intrusion detection parameters. To configure the intrusion detection parameters of the sensor module, click on the GSM Config tab and select the Sensor Module subtab. The event threshold value sets the sensitivity of the sensor module to gate vibrations. Raise the value to make the sensor less sensitive. Lower the value to make the sensor more sensitive. The event window value is the number of seconds that must pass before another disturbance is considered a separate event. The event count is the number of events that must occur before an alarm is generated. The alarm window is the length of time in seconds before the event count is reset back to zero. The alarm hold time is the length of time in seconds that an alarm is held active. The system will not report additional alarms until this time expires. Click the Download button to save your changes and make them active. To test the values, click the Sensor Modules Plot tool. Click Record and observe the plot while tapping or climbing the gate. After observing the results, click Stop and close the plot tool. Adjust the event threshold and other detection values as required. After optimizing your detection settings, the next step is to configure how and when the sensor module notifies your alarm system during an intrusion event. Enable local bypass alarm to disable all intrusion alarms when the sensor module's auxiliary input is activated. For example, the gate is open. Control activation alarm specifies a FlexZone or UltraLink processor relay output to activate when the gate intrusion alarm occurs. Step 3. Configure supervision settings. Supervision settings control how and when the sensor module notifies your alarm system in the event of tampering. Supervision alarms are generated by changes to the sensor module's orientation. For example, removing it from the gate, as well as by opening its enclosure.
Supervision mode configures how the sensor module differentiates between expected orientation on the gate and potential tampering. Select the mode designed for your gate type.
Mode 1. Designed for swinging gates. Ignores horizontal changes in the Z-axis. Mode 2. Designed for vertical pivot lift gates. Ignores orientation changes in X and Y axis. Mode 3. Designed for sliding gates. All orientation changes trigger a supervision alarm. Supervision tolerance configures how sensitive the sensor module is to changes in orientation. Lower value to increase sensitivity, raise value to lower sensitivity. Enable local bypass supervision to disable supervision alarms when the sensor module's auxiliary input is in an alarm state. Control activation supervision specifies a FlexZone or UltraLink processor relay output to activate when a sensor module supervision alarm occurs. If the sensor module is generating supervision alarms after installation, you may need to reset its default orientation. On the GSM status tab, click the reset button. The sensor module now considers the current orientation as secure. Any attempt to remove it from the gate will trigger a supervision alarm. Step 4. Configure equipment failure notification. The FlexZone processor can notify your site's alarm system if the wireless gate sensor generates diagnostic errors, enters a fault condition, the wireless link is lost, or has a low battery or low solar charge. Receiver failure specifies a FlexZone or UltraLink processor relay output to activate if the receiver card installed inside the FlexZone processor stops functioning. Diagnostic fault specifies a FlexZone or UltraLink processor relay output to activate if the sensor module experiences a communications failure, a hardware failure, an enclosure tamper, or low power condition. Step 5. Configure auxiliary input. The auxiliary input configuration parameters control how the sensor unit's input for monitoring gate contacts operates. You can configure the supervision resistor settings as well as any FlexZone or UltraLink to activate when the gate contact is asserted or enters a supervision state. Remember to download any changes you make to the processor to make them active. You can save a local copy of the configuration to your PC by clicking the Save button. This concludes our video on wireless gate sensor configuration. If you need help when using the UCM software, click the Help button. The online help explains each parameter and function in detail.